So I just want you to make sure that when you make good money, you put it in its proper place. Money is good to have. But if you could exchange a great marriage and a great relationship with your kids and only make 50 grand versus being a billionaire, but can't nobody stand you, you'd probably go for the 50 grand and have a healthy family. Does that make sense? And you'd be healthy. Amen. That's the last. The highest level of success is when you get through all your hurt and your pain and you become whole. Because here's the deal. If you make money, you can teach me that. But if you're not whole, you can't lead me. No, you got to hear what I'm saying. It doesn't make us bad people. If you were 3, ain't nobody tripping. If you were 4, ain't nobody tripping. But the world would not follow the 21-year-old Eric Thomas. Let me just be clear on that. The world ain't about to follow the 21-year-old Eric. My wife wasn't even following me. My wife left. My wife wasn't even feeling me and what I was doing. Are you hearing what I'm saying? No, nobody would follow the 26-year-old Eric. I was still a work in progress. But you will follow the 49-year-old Eric. Why? Because in many areas, I'm further along the road than you are. I'm not better than you, but I've made a commitment to be wealthier earlier than you. I started to, I peeped game early. I saw people with money and was like, oh, it ain't that. I'm like, whoa, money must not be the thing then, because it seemed like folks with money doing some dumb stuff. So let's go over it real quick. I want to make it clear. Wealth is an abundance of something. Is that clear? It means you got so much stuff, you ain't even got to say you got it. That's how you really know you rich. Like, you look at Bill Gates, he don't never had nothing on. You look at the rapper, my man just got some money. He got it all of it right there. He looking to get robbed. I'm like, bro, you just got robbed me all over you. In your mouth, on your every, you walking around, you got a bag, a Louis bag with millions of dollars in the Louis bag. That you're not whole. I'm not trying to be funny, but you on Instagram with all your money on the tape. You're not whole. I've seen some of these dudes in the mall. What up, ET? What up? We kicking it. I see them. They got 9, 10 people. When people see me on the block, they be like, yo, E, is that you? I'm like, yeah, why you say that? Where's your entourage? I say, it costs too much to have an entourage. It costs way too much, bro. I ain't trying to have 9. I'm grown. Like, for real, I'm a whole, like, I used to trip on my father and I had to get through that, but I'm a whole grown man. I do not need 6 grown men with me 24/7. I'm just being real. I'm married. I don't need 6 grown men around me and my wife at all times. Maybe I'm old school, but I'm cool on that. I don't need grown men, and I'm grateful for the men that are here who step up, but I don't need nobody to carry my bag. I don't have an inferiority complex. Matter of fact, when I'm with you and we on the road, I want them to think you the number one motivational speaker in the world. Not I'm the number one and you carrying my bags. I'm a grown man who's healthy. I don't need to make other young men feel bad about themselves to make myself feel good. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I'm whole. I'm healthy. So, are you telling me not to get a Maserati? I'm telling you, if you want one, get 2. I'm telling you, if you like to carry Louis bags, get 6. I'm telling you to be in abundance. As a matter of fact, I want you to have so many Louis bags, you can give some out. I want you to be able to walk up to a group of kids who working hard and they can't, and you give it to them and say, yo, this is what can happen to you if you keep going. So I want you to have money. I'm just saying, don't act like money is a PhD. It's not. It is the easiest part of wealth that you can accumulate. That's the one you can get the easiest. So let's not focus on that one since that's the easiest one. Let's try to get to the top, which is whole. Because when you whole, you attract whole. And then you start, your ceiling is the next generation's floor. Your ceiling is the next generation's floor. My son called me the other day like, Dad, I'm with this wedding planner. I was like, Bad, how much she charge? He's like, 20,000. I was like, oh, I could, his mom was like, look, I could just stop working for your dad for a couple weeks and just be your wedding planner. 20 grand? He's like, well, we got another one. She about 5'10". I'm saying, what a life. The fact that you got a wedding planner. When me and Dee put our wedding together 21 years later, we went to the courthouse first. 21 years later, we was doing it all by ourselves with the church family. You know the lady at the church who a wedding planner, but she ain't really a wedding planner? But she want to do weddings though. And she feel, because she saw it on YouTube, she's sweet with it. That's who helped us with ours. My man 24 years old with a wedding planner. Like, unbelievable. I called my man 2-3 weeks ago. He was with Pop, the San Antonio Spurs. He in there with the coach chopping up. I was like, what's up, son? I'm gonna have to call you back. I'm sitting here with Pop right quick, son. Dad, he's just showing me some stuff. I'm like, what? You with who? With Pop. I'm like, oh, okay. Call me back. Call me back then. You know what I'm saying? When you get a chance. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to interrupt that. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So when we are whole and we get over stuff and we get strong, then we pass that to the next generation and they get stronger. Does that make sense? So I'm on wealth, not money. But money is a part of, I'm not on money, I'm on, and wealth is a part of, money is, but money ain't necessarily. Does that make sense? So if I was you, I wouldn't go for money because money don't necessarily mean, but I would go to wealth because inside of wealth is, okay. I just want to take my time, make sure you're getting this. So while you chasing money, you might get money, but then you might have nothing else. Are you hearing me? I talked to a multimillionaire this was about a month ago. I started coaching him in his marriage. My man said to me, yo, E, I don't know, bro. I said, you don't know what? He said, I don't know which one is more important, my career or my family. I was like, okay, cool. I ain't mad at you. I already knew what he was. He was an ID. I'm feeling my man. My man like, yo, E, my whole life, I got to go get this bread. I was like, cool, I ain't mad at you. First of all, how much you got to pay me? I want to know how serious to take this. You know what I'm saying? Because you just told me you got bread. So how much bread do you have? You just told me you got bread and you can make bread. So cool, how much you got? So he told me, I probably got about 10,000. I was like, okay, cool, we could do something with that. All right, so here's the deal. You don't have a problem with whatever. He said, okay, I do. I don't know which one. I said, no, I can help you in 30 seconds. He said, okay, which one? I said, okay, tell me something. If you made all that money, but you lost your wife and your child, could you make that money and be happy by yourself? He was like, absolutely not. I said, well, then you just answered the question. You just answered the question. What's more important? My wife and my kids. Okay, you ready to do something about it? Yeah, okay, here go my Cash App. Okay, let's get that out the way first. You feel me? Let's get that out the way first, because I want to make sure you're serious. You know what I'm saying? You talking, but I want to make sure you, once the check cash, then I know you're serious. And I said, bruh, here's all you got to do. Your wife is a high S and a high C. All she wants is time. And because she's a high C, you could tell her when and do it the same time every time, and she's going to be geeked. I said, okay, do me a favor. I'm gonna do this one for free. I'm gonna call your wife and ask your wife what she wants. And I'm gonna tell you what she wants. And all you gotta do is do what she's want. We finished for the first month. We finished. I call wifey, I love it. She's an S and a C, so she's very predictable. She's just like, I just wanted to start going to church. Okay, bet. Hey, bruh, I'm gonna need you to start going to church. He's like, E, I ain't feeling church. I said nothing about feeling church. I said, your wife wants you to go to church. You don't have to feel it. Just sit there for an hour and a half and look entertained. It's not rocket science. This is wealth. You go to church. I said, bro, you getting over scot-free. I wish somebody would call Didi and ask Didi what she needs to be happy. It's going to be a 20-page document. I'm not gonna be able to do it and go to work. Sister girl said she just wants you to go to church. I said, so here's what I need you to do. Sunday, I need you to go. And I said, bruh, you scot-free, bruh. I said, bruh, you white. You white, bruh. Y'all church service don't last but an hour, bruh. You solid. You acting like you black and you gonna be in that joker all day. You feel me? I said, no, I feel you. If you black, you might have to go to that joke at 9:30 in the morning for whatever little Bible study you're having. 11, you're going to be there from 11 till they finish falling out and hitting the. I'm like, whatever you do, people in my church always be like, the B3, don't you bring that joke into my church. Because when you bring that, it's like an extra hour and a half. They hit it. Dun, 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 dun. It takes another hour and a half. Like, don't bring that instrument in my church. Sit that somewhere. Right? Are you hearing what I'm saying? And then after that, you got potluck. Like, you go to a black church, for real, it could be all day long. I said, bro, you go to a white church, y'all get in at 10. You could be at the Olive Garden at 11:30, bro, with your food sitting there, bro. You tripping. An hour to change your marriage? I said, there's one other thing. She wants prayer meeting. He He was like, prayer meeting? I was like, that's 2 hours out of the week. And then do me a favor, after church, don't mess around and invite a couple people over and play board games. My man did exactly what I told him to do. I called his wife. How you doing? She's like, I'm just fantastic. How did you do it? I was like, for another 10 next month, I can show you how I did it. I can show you how I did it. If you want to know. Now, if you don't want to know, just be happy. But if you want to know, I can show you how I did it. Called my man, like, how you feeling? He was like, yo, E is crazy. The board game? My man was blown out there. I said, what y'all play? Sunk Your Battleship. He was like, it was crazy. We brought the video, we brought the game, and then I brought some food, and I did what you told me to do. I got us some roses. I got the roses, and the family came over. And when the family came over, we played, and then everybody went to sleep, and I spent about 30 minutes just talking to her one-on-one. She melted. I said, all right, bro, next month, 10, and then we'll talk. And he was like, yo, E, I'm good. I said, no, you're not. You're a D. You're going to do it for a month or two, and then you're going to stop. You need me to tell you you can do it. So I was like, you ain't got to pay me no more information, but you are going to have to pay me to get you focused, because I guarantee you, you're going to go back to your bad habits of putting work before your wife. And sure enough, he called me 3 months later. E, we having a problem. I blew up. I said, what happened? He said, I blew up. I said, what happened? He said, I told her that I was going to come home at 5, and I got home at 9, and she said something to me about it, and I blew up. And I was like, good. Oh, you blew up. Man, that's terrible. Are you feeling what I'm saying? Good. So let's go through it. An abundance, plentiful supply of a particular desirable thing. ET's version, relationship, financial, spiritual, mental, emotional, income, impact, and influence. This is why I'm telling you that. I want to explain everything. The reason why I'm telling you that you need all, because if you're in the league and you only play defense, there's a chance that you can get traded or you can get kicked out the league. If you only score, there's a chance that you can get traded or you can get kicked out the league. If you MJ, you play offense and defense, you're not going nowhere. Why? Because you're well-rounded. And you can't find that every day. Why? Because the average kid growing up just want to hoop, he just want to score. Or the average kid who can't score, he learns how to play defense. But it's a monster who can do both. The reason why I'm telling you to do all, because if you make money and your wife ain't happy, you still not happy. If you got money and you caked out, you can travel the world, but you don't got nobody to share it with, it's not the same. If you got you just and your kids and you making bread, but your kids acting a fool, you can't even enjoy it. This is why I say you need all. This is why I get up in the morning and pray. I don't pray because I'm no religious freak. I didn't grow up in church. I pray because it works. I don't pray because I grew up in the church and my parents is making me pray every day. They ain't calling me like, did you pray today, boy? I pray because I pray and it works. I have faith and it works. I don't know what it is about the spirituality in the word, but you do what it tells you to do. It works. When you pay your tithe, it works. He opens up the windows of heaven. It works. Does this make sense? I don't try to have a great relationship with my wife because I grew up just trying to have a great relationship with my wife. I didn't have a great relationship with her. And when I would pray, I couldn't hardly pray because I'm thinking about her. And because I love her and I want to do right by her, when I didn't do right, it bothered me. I'm not sitting here because I'm a good person. I'm sitting here because when I didn't do the right thing, it bothered me. I couldn't go to sleep. So I figured you might as well do what's right, because if you do what's right, you're going to feel better. And when you feel better, you do better. When you do wrong, you don't feel, okay, if you got a conscience, when you do wrong, you can't even enjoy it when you're doing something you ain't supposed to be doing. Are you here? So I learned at a young age that if I'm wealthy in my relationships, I can make a phone call and get to my son in a way I can't get to my son. And it makes sense. Eh? You a D, he a D. So of course you would be able to relate to him in a way I can't relate to him. This is the power of relationships.